Hare Krishna. The lower our consciousness, the lesser is our contribution. When our consciousness is high, we can think about things bigger than ourselves. And we can, by thinking about something bigger than ourselves, we can make a positive contribution to things. But the lower our consciousness becomes sunk into ourselves. Me and not even my own desire. So for example, when we are in goodness, we can think about others and we can think about how others are, what situation others are going through, and we can be empathic. In mode of passion, in Rajoguna, we are primarily, we can think about others, but only in terms of those to whom we are attached, and whether they are in a good condition so that they can give us pleasure. But in the mode of ignorance, our consciousness gets so sunk into ourselves that we can't even think about others too much. We're just lost in our own world, so we cannot contribute. Krishna talks about the three modes of material nature in the 14th chapter, and in the 13th text of the 14th chapter, he says, Aprakasho pravrittischa pramado mohevacha tamasyetani jayante vruddhe purnandana. So he says, aprakasho apravrittischa. Aprakasha is lack of light. Now Krishna has talked about in 14.11, prakasha, he uses sarvadvareshu dehesmin prakasham upajayate jnanam yata tada vidya vivruddham sattvam ityuta. So in 14.11 he has said that when all the doors of the senses are illumined with knowledge, at that time, that is the characteristic of the mode of goodness. So prakasha he uses as a shorthand to refer to goodness. And pravritti, which he refers to in the next verse, in 14.12 he says, Lobha pravrittirarambha karmanam ashamahaspruha rajasyetani jayante ruddhe bharatarshabha. So lobha pravrittirarambha. Pravritti means vigorous action according to one's inclination, according to one's attachment, according to one's infatuation. So pravritti he uses as a shorthand to refer to the mode of passion. So here in 14.13 he says, aprakasho apravrittischa pramado moha evacha. So aprakasha apravritti. There is neither illumination nor is there action. Moha evacha moha. There is only illusion. So then, that means one is only imagining, maybe things can be like this, maybe things can be like that, maybe this, maybe that. And one doesn't do anything practical about it. This is tamasyetani jayante. That is tamoguna. Tamasyetani jayante. Vivruddhe. This is what happens when the mode of ignorance predominates. So the lower is our consciousness, the less we can contribute constructively. And of course, one characteristic of the mode of ignorance, tamoguna, is also destruction. So far from making a positive contribution, when such people act, they don't have illumination and their action is not guided by illumination, their action is motivated by destruction. So when we practice spirituality, when we meditate and cultivate devotion to Krishna, by this our consciousness rises. And the more our consciousness rises, the more our contribution also rises. So rather than thinking that by being spiritual we are being self-centered, rather we should understand by being unspiritual, we sink into ourselves and we become more and more self-centered by being unspiritual. Because when our consciousness goes down, then we can think everything only in our terms. You know, I want to eat this, I want to enjoy this, this person should do like this, this person should do like that. And then we consume, we don't contribute. And that's why if society is to be improved, if we want to do something worthwhile in our life, we should know that it's not just only in terms of the work that we do physically, not just the practical actions that we do, but also the devotional cultivation that we do, that will also increase our contribution. And ultimately, it is whatever contribution we make in this world, that is not going to last. And we are not going to last with it. We are going to die. But by the practice of spirituality, we contribute to our own spiritual growth. We contribute to the elevation of our consciousness and to our eternal liberation. Thus, the striving to raise our consciousness brings auspiciousness, both in this life, in this world, as well as in the next life, in the next world for us. Thank you. Hare Krishna.